to start, we are going to solve some examples which are dependent on the volume of sphere. Okay, so this which examples we are going to solve today, that is the last worksheet which is given. Okay, so first problem is the diameter of the internal and external surfaces of a hollow hemispherical shell are 6 cm and 10 cm respectively. If it is melted and recast into a solid cylinder of diameter 14 cm, find the height of cylinder. Okay, we have to find out height of the cylinder. Okay, so here that spherical shell is given. See here, the diameter of the internal and external surfaces of a hollow hemispherical shell are 6 cm and 10 cm. Means this diameter is 6 cm. Internal diameter is 6 cm and this external diameter is, external is 10 cm. This 10 cm. Okay. Now, what happens after this? If it is melted, means definitely here we need to find out volume of this spherical shell. Okay, so first we will try to find out volume of this spherical shell. Okay, so now here what is given? Internal radius we are taking always small r. Okay, that is what will be the radius? 6 by 2, that is 3 cm. Diameter is 6 cm divided by 2, that is 3 cm. Now external radius we use capital R, that is 10 by 2, that is 5 cm. Okay, now we are going to find out volume of spherical shell. How to find out volume of spherical shell? Is equals to which formula we use? 2 by 3 pi r cube. Okay, pi r cube, this minus 2 by 3 pi small r cube. Okay, because we need to find out the difference between its radius. Okay, so capital R means external radius is 5 cm and small r means internal radius, that is 3 cm. Okay, so now we can take 2 by 3 pi common. So that I am taking now 2 upon 3 pi in bracket, what is going to remain? Capital R cube minus small r cube. Okay, so now here 2 by 3 into pi, capital R is 5 cm, so 5 cube minus r, small r is 3 cube. Okay, so 2 upon 3 pi, 5 cube is 125 minus 3 cube is 27. Okay, so now here 2 by 3 pi, this 125 minus 27, it will be 98. Okay, so here we will get 2 into 98, so that will be 196 upon 3 pi. So this is the volume of this spherical shell. Okay, how we got this? See, the difference between the radius we have taken, so directly we can use this also. Understood? Now what we will do, see, after this, if it is melted and recast into a solid cylinder of diameter 14 cm. Okay, it is recasted into a solid cylinder whose, what is given? 14 cm. Diameter is 14 cm. Diameter is given 14 cm. Okay, find the height. Here we have to find out height. Understood? So what we will use here to find out the definitely volume of this cylinder and volume of this will be same. Okay, so volume of cylinder is equals to which formula we use for to find out volume of cylinder? Pi r square h. So pi we will keep as it is. Radius, what is the radius? 14 cm. Diameter, 14 cm is the diameter, means definitely radius will be 7 cm. So I am taking here 7 square multiply by h. Okay, so here 7 square is 49 pi h is the volume of cylinder which is recasted from the spherical shell to the cylinder. Okay. So this volume is 49 pi h and this volume is 196 by 3 pi. Okay. So definitely both the volumes are same because it is recasted. The cylinder is recasted from the spherical shell. So both the volumes are same. So we can equate, we can compare this 196 by 3 pi is equals to 49 pi h. Okay. Because the same material is used for to make this. So from these two, here if I am saying this is first one, this is I will say second one. So from first and second we can say 196 or 49 pi h is equals to 196 upon 3 pi. Okay, so in both the sides, in LHS and RHS, which is the common factor pi, so it will be cancelled, pi and this side pi we can cancel. Okay, so what is going to remain, h is equals to 196 by 3, this 49 will divide there, so multiply by 49. Okay, so here 49 fours are, okay, so height is equals to 4 by 3 centimeters, or we can convert this into decimal also. Okay, got it everybody? So see here once again what we have done, volume of spherical shell we need to find out. Okay, spherical shell means you will get there two radii, internal and external. Okay, so we need to find out the difference between that radius. Okay, so which was given, pi keep as it is, don't write their value because finally we are going to equate them. So pi is going to be cancelled. If you will put here pi, then again the calculations we need to do, some more calculations we need to do, and it will take time. So we must know what we are going to, which method we are going to apply to solve whole example. Okay, so here we got 196 by 3 pi and here volume of cylinder pi r square h, radius or diameter was given. From diameter we have to find out radius and you will get this 49 pi h, and finally we have to equate them. So pi value is 22 by 7 and it will be cancelled because it is available in LHS and RHS. So h is equal to this 196 upon 3 multiplied by 49. So h is equal to 4 by 3 centimeter. So that is the required answer. Okay. Okay. Our second problem is, a lead pencil consists of a cylinder of wood with a solid cylinder of graphite filled in the interior. The diameter of the pencil is 7 mm and the diameter of the graphite is 1 mm. If length of the pencil is 14 cm, find the volume of wood and that of graphite. Okay, so here we have to find out volume of wood and graphite. Once again we will see, I am reading here first sentence, a lead pencil consists of a cylinder of wood with a solid cylinder of graphite filled in the interior. Okay, means somewhere like that you will get figure. This is suppose that is graphite and this is pencil, this is wood. Okay, so definitely here afterwards what is given, see, the diameter of the pencil is 7 mm, diameter of the pencil is 7 mm, okay, and the diameter of the graphite is 1 mm, diameter of the graphite is 1 mm, so diameter of graphite is 1 mm, that is given. Okay, and what is given, if length of the pencil is 14 cm, length of the pencil is 14 cm, means what? Length of pencil means length of graphite also and length of this pencil means wood also, wooden structure, that is 14 cm. Okay, then find the volume of wood and that of graphite. Okay, so here one thing we will come to know, the this is both are cylindrical, graphite also and this wood structure also, both are cylindrical. So here we need to find out volume of pencil whose diameter is 7 mm, okay, and volume of graphite whose diameter is 1 mm. Okay, so first we will try to find out here volume of graphite. Okay, volume of graphite. So first we are going to think about graphite. Okay, so what is diameter given? Diameter is given 1 mm, Okay, but we need to change the unit because this is given in centimeter and other dimensions are given in millimeter. So 1 mm is equals to 1 by 10 centimeter. This is diameter. This is diameter, and we need to find out radius. So to find out radius, we will divide here by 2. So radius is equals to 1 by 10 divided by 2, means multiply by 1 by 2. So that is 1 by 20 centimeters. Okay, so this is the radius. Okay, now we can find out and length. Length is given 14 centimeter. So that we will consider h is equal to 14 centimeter. Okay, so volume of graphite is equals to pi r square h. Volume of graphite is equals to pi r square h. So it will be 22 by 7. Pi is 22 by 7. Radius is 1 by 20 into 1 by 20 into height is 14 centimeter. So it will be centimeter cube. Okay. So now here we can 7 ones are 7. 7 2s are 14. 2 ones are 2. 10s are here 5. Here 11. Okay. So what is remain here? 11 upon 25s are 100 centimeter cube. So here we can write 0.11 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of graphite. This is the volume of graphite. Understood? What we have done, millimeter we need to convert into centimeter. Otherwise centimeter also we can convert into millimeter, but unit must be same. Okay, so this we have done, and with the help of cylinder, volume of cylinder we got here volume of graphite. Okay, again same thing we will do volume of pencil. Now volume of pencil that is also cylindrical. So here again we will use pi r square h, same formula we are going to use, but here what is the height of the cylinder? Height of the cylinder is 14 centimeter, and radius is, diameter is given 7 mm. Diameter is given 7 mm. So radius will be, this 7 mm we need to convert into centimeter. So 7 by 10 centimeter. Okay. So radius, how will find out radius? Radius is equals to 7 by 10 divided by 2, means multiply by 1 by 2. So that is 7 by 20 centimeter. 7 by 20 centimeter. Okay. So volume of pencil is equals to again pi r square h. Here radius is different. Okay, so now here 22 by 7 multiply by radius is 7 by 20 into 7 by 20 into height is 14 centimeter cube. Okay, so now here again we can cancel this 7 will be cancelled. Now here 11, here it will be 10, here 5, here 7. Okay, so what is remaining here? 7 7s are 11 7s are 77 multiply by this 7 divided by 25s are 100. Okay, so here it will be 539 upon 100. This product is 539 upon 100, so it will be 5.39 centimeter cube. Okay, so this is the volume of pencil, this is the volume of graphite. Okay, now what is the question? See, find the volume of wood and that of graphite. Okay, so how will get the answer? We need to subtract this. Required answer will be volume of pencil minus volume of graphite. Okay, so you will get volume of wood. Volume of wood is equals to 5.39 minus 0.11 centimeter cube. Okay, so it will be 9 minus 1, 8, 3 minus 1, 2, and 5.28 centimeter cube. This is the required volume. Understood? Okay, last problem from the worksheet is, a patient in a hospital is given soup daily in a cylindrical bowl of diameter 7 cm. If the bowl is filled with soup to a height of 4 cm, how much soup the hospital has to prepare daily to serve 250 patients? Understood? Very simple question. Here we need to find out volume of that bowl, okay, multiply by 250. That is our required answer. Very simple question. So what is given? It is cylindrical bowl. So diameter of cylindrical bowl is equals to 7 cm. Okay, so radius will be 7 by 2 cm. Radius is equals to 7 by 2 cm, or 3.5 also we can take. If the bowl is filled with the soup to a height of 4 cm. Okay, so height is given 4 cm. Understood? So we can find out volume of cylindrical bowl, that is pi r square h. So that is 22 by 7 multiplied by radius is 7 by 2 into 7 by 2 into height is 4. It will be centimeter cube. Okay. So now here this 7 will be cancelled. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Then this 2 will be cancelled. So 22 7s are 154 centimeter cube. This is the volume of that bowl, cylindrical bowl. Okay, like that, how many people are there? 250 patients are there. So we need to multiply by 250. Finish. Okay, so how much soup? So amount of soup is equals to 250 multiplied by 154 centimeter cube. Okay, so here we need to solve this, that is 0. Thirty-eight thousand five hundred centimeter cube soup is required to serve 250 patients. Okay, now this we can give in liters also. Okay, if I want to convert this into liter, then what I will do? 38,500 divided by 1000 liters. Okay, so it will be 38,500 liters. Okay, so that is our required answer. Very simple question. This question is from NCERT book. Okay.